All right, everyone, Christian here. Did you know a Klaviyo abandoned cart sequence or flow can give you much more customization and targeting than your Shopify default flow? In this video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. There are a lot of reasons why someone abandons a cart. Perhaps the shopper didn't have their credit card in front of them, or they wanted to maybe browse your site a little bit more before actually making that decision to purchase. Whatever the reason is for leaving mid-checkout, most often is not because they're no longer interested in your actual product. So in Klaviyo, you can fully customize the content of the email and potentially even SMS, add multiple messages and branch the flow based on things like the value of the item in the card and a lot more things. Now, you'll want to definitely turn off any default platform abandoned cart messages that you may have on Shopify so that you're not double messaging anyone. So we'll show you how to do that here in a second. Now, creating the abandoned cart flow. Let's start with that. What we want to do is go to the Klaviyo dashboard and go to flows. Now in here, you'll see the back in stock flow that we had from a previous video that we created, but we have all the ideas down here, which you might be able to see. Let's do create flow. And then once you click on create flow, you'll see the first one should be that one. Like it says right here, abandoned cart reminder. It's the standard 7 out of 10 shopping carts are abandoned. You can recover more sales by doing that. Now, the most common type of abandoned cart flow actually uses started checkout as the actual event. So it's a common misconception. It's not when they add to cart that the flow starts. It's when actually they start checkout, which in Shopify, typically depending on your website and how you have your theme set up, you can go to that cart page, a dedicated cart page, or sometimes they could do the cart drawer, but that step doesn't get counted. It's whenever they go to the next step and they actually click on checkout or get started with checkout, depending on how you have your verbiage for that next button. And then that would actually take it and start your checkout. That's where you actually start putting in your email information, your shipping information, and all that kind of stuff. You can, however, create an added to cart flow in the flows library. Towards the end of the video, we'll show you how to do that. So you can have both up running, the abandoned cart checkout when, I guess the abandoned checkout, if you will, and then the actual true abandoned cart. Now, when it comes to this one, again, it's pretty straightforward. They give you a little synopsis, right, of what will happen. The trigger, again, when someone starts a checkout, wait 4 hours. It has the email number one, wait 20 hours, and then send email number two. It does have in here that you have the prerequisites, right? So you want to make sure that you're connected with Klaviyo. And then the other one is we have not received any recent placed order events. So if you think there might be a problem, contact your success team. So again, this has to do more with the back end of your store and if people are actually going through the process, right, of actually adding to cart. So you might get that little warning message there if you're just starting out. So we're gonna click on create flow. Now, before I show you some of the content that we have here in this flow, I just wanna say bienvenidos. My name is Christian Piñon, one of the co-founders here at BitBrainy. We're an e-commerce growth agency that specializes in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online. We drop new videos every week, so make sure that you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out. So what content to include? Obviously, like I said, this automatically gives you some of the emails already in here, so you don't have to like necessarily think too much about it, right? Now, the actual content on each of the emails is gonna be maybe a little bit different, right? Depending on your customer and your brand as a whole. Now, Klaviyo's default abandoned cart flow contains dynamic block content and go to cart buttons that are unique. It's like a unique e-commerce integration. So those types of sections in the emails, I wouldn't touch because that will take you directly to whatever product that particular customer was interested in or had in their cart, essentially. Now, another thing to think about here, and I'm gonna click on one of these emails just so you can kind of see, click on that and then click on edit and just show you how simple they are, edit content. Thanks for stopping by. We saved all your great items in your cart. So when you're ready to buy, simply just click this button. It has them just a little preview of the actual product that they might have in their cart. So again, all this data here is dynamic, so it'll automatically populate. And then the big button says return to your cart. Obviously, we would want to brand this a little bit better for our store. So maybe add some of our colors, add our logo. I mean, it has the social media icons towards the bottom, but you might be tempted to maybe include other products or maybe best sellers or stuff like that. We would advise against that as it can lower your conversion rate, right? The purpose of these emails is for them to return to cart and actually finish what they started. So again, the language that you use should encourage people to actually reach out, push the button, that they have questions to, you know, answer any questions that they may have. But the main driver for these emails is gonna be to go and return to cart and complete that order. And then as you can see here, like I said, you would want to include logos, colors, and all that stuff to make sure that it matches your brand. And once you're done, obviously you can also change the subject line. They do have, you know, a default subject line for these emails. So this one says, it looks like you left something behind. You can change, make all those changes right within here when you click on edit. For that particular email. Now you can do the same thing by clicking on email number two. And obviously you can add more emails if you wanted to. This is the default. So it's good to test around and see what works for you, what doesn't work. Maybe you can test the wait 4 hours to something a little bit different just to make sure that it works better for you. I do want to show you here as well on the actual trigger. And I think this shows you, yeah, the filters. That person has started the checkout, but also they placed order 0 times since starting this flow. So that means that that person started checkout and didn't actually place the order. And then the next one here, the other filter is checkout started 0 times since started this flow. So maybe they've done this multiple times and you don't want to necessarily send them multiple of these abandoned cart emails so close together, essentially. And then once you're in the main flow here, also, again, if you wanted to add more things, you have these action blocks and the timing and the logic over here. So you're able to just drag the next thing. So another time delay, you set that up, and then you can also, you know, add SMS messages or email in there. Now, when to actually send your messages and how many. So deciding when to send your first abandoned cart can be maybe a little bit difficult. Obviously, Klaviyo and Shopify, they have some of the industry averages, I would say. But as a rule of thumb, we recommend using, you know, what they have here. So between 2 to 4 hours after someone starts checkout is a good practice. And then sending the second email 1 or 2 days later. Based on research from thousands of Klaviyo e-commerce customers, they found that sending 2 to 3 abandoned cart messages in your flow leads to optimal performance. More than that, it usually starts to go downhill a little bit. Hey, I want to let you in a little secret. We're using a tool called Triple Well for all of our client and group coaching members. And this powerhouse of a tool allows us to see LTV for a customer at 30, 60, and 90 days. But what we're most excited about is the estimated action of customers. Imagine being able to send out emails, like some of the ones that we're talking about here, or run ads to customers who are likely to buy from you a second or third time. Knowing when to send out these marketing messages, it's very, very powerful. It gives you the data and analytics to make those decisions. So Triple Well centralizes all the metrics from all the tools that you use right into your pocket. They simplify, inform, and save you time. Make sure to check out the link in the description below. Now, before we move on here, I just wanna make sure, after you've basically edited all your emails, set your additional flows, if you wanted to set an additional flow. So I'm gonna delete this one right here. I'm just gonna leave it bare bones, simple, just like we had it. The next thing is to update the action statuses. We're gonna go live, update statuses. Now that we've started the flow here on Klaviyo, we wanna make sure that we go back to Shopify and turn off the default one. So we're gonna go to settings, we're gonna go to checkout, and we're gonna scroll. And then you see the section that says abandoned checkout emails. You want to make sure that this one is unchecked. So send abandoned checkout emails automatically. I'm going to save on that. And so now we have it turned off inside of Shopify. Close that. We're going to go back to Klaviyo. Let me refresh this page. Okay, now what about the true abandoned cart email flow? It is important to note that you can instead create a similar flow based solely around when someone actually adds an item to their cart but doesn't go to checkout. This is called added to cart trigger, and it can actually be found in the flows library. So let's go and check that out. So we're gonna go back here in Klaviyo. We're under flows, we're gonna create a flow, and then let's type in the same thing, abandon. And then in here, this is the one that we just set up, the abandoned cart reminder standard, and it has this Shopify logo right there. The one that we're talking about here is the added to cart trigger, and it has like a little gear icon with Shopify in there. So we click on that, and we'll see that it looks very similar, almost exactly the same, I would say. But instead of the trigger is the only thing that's different here. So it's when someone actually adds to cart, not necessarily when they reach that checkout page. Now in here, it does require you to do an extra thing. So it has the X right here. So this says this flow requires setting up a special added to cart metric. So let's click on learn more. And this will show you exactly what you need to do here. If you are good with the abandoned cart checkout that we created initially, then you're good with that. Now, if you wanna learn how to do this, it does require a little bit of adding a little bit of custom code to your store. So if you're not super familiar with that, just be very careful when you're making changes changes to your code in the back end. There are multiple things that you'll need to take into consideration here. First off, you just need to figure out how your theme handles the cart. This particular post right here gives you three different ways or three different snippets, right? And you just need to figure out which snippet is the one that you need to use. So I know it's maybe a little bit complex, but it's good to do this. Now, I believe if we look in here, I guess the first question is, does your store redirect customers to another page, such as a checkout page or a cart page, after they've added an item to their cart? If the answer is no, then you should use snippet number one. If the answer is yes, you need to go to number two. So let's go and check on the Totally Nines kit, so our store, and let's see what happens when we add to cart. Okay, so when we add to cart, it doesn't take us to a different page. As you can see, it has a drawer, what is called a drawer cart, where it just drops down, or it can come from the side sometimes. If you have those, then that means that it doesn't take you to an additional page. Now, so if the answer is no, you should use snippet number one. So again, just to make sure. So yeah, so let's go to snippet number one. Now for buttons without redirects, and obviously you would want to, on this link, it will walk you through. So if the answer is yes, then you'll want to, I believe what you need to make sure is to look inside of the code. So you'll want to use a browser like Google Chrome, and you'll want to click on inspect. You just follow the rules, the instructions here. It will walk you through exactly what you need to find within your code. So it's either, you're looking for either ID or a class when it comes to your actual button. So it's very, very simple. Now, because ours didn't have that, and a lot of themes actually do have that drawer cart, we're gonna go with snippet number one. So this is for buttons without redirects. Now, we have all this script page right here, so we're gonna click and copy all this, command copy, and then where to put that, we're gonna click on that link. So where should I paste my snippet? So it tells you right here, we're gonna go to online store themes, customize, I'm gonna do homepage drop down. Products, default products, we're gonna add a section, and we're gonna select custom liquid. Okay, perfect. So we're gonna go here to our online store, and then themes, we're gonna click on customize. And then what it tells us to do is go to the product page, and then right within here, click on that. We're gonna add a block, we're gonna do custom liquid, and then in here, we're gonna paste our code. Now, once you've added that piece of code, you just want to go back over here, back to the flows, and you want to find the add to cart trigger, and it has a little gear icon with Shopify, and you go through the same steps that we just did for the previous one. It will have the exact same layout and flow of it. It's just, the only difference again is just that trigger. Hey, if you like what you see, please consider clicking on that like button. So what's next after setting these up, right? Well, I have maybe more video ideas for you in the future. We can do things like purchasers versus non-purchasers, domestic versus international, product category versus actual products. So if you want to take that abandoned cart flow to the next level, then comment down below. Let us know if you wanna see more of these abandoned cart metrics and abandoned cart flows, and even adding SMS, right? Again, just trying to get people to finalize that purchase. As a little bonus, I do want you to check out reallygoodemails.com for some inspiration on just how the other companies lay out their emails, right? When it comes to the actual design of them. I know we didn't touch too hard on the actual design of these emails, but if you go to reallygoodemails.com, you'll see some examples on even your particular niche or set of products, and then looking at those specific emails, like the abandoned cart, you can see how they're using the copy, how they're using images, and what exactly they're including within those emails. See you on the next one.